I'm Kirsty Meakin from Naio Nails. In this video, we are going to do a Fendi nail. I'm super excited. Not just because we're doing a designer nail, because we all know I love a designer nail, but because we have Meg in with us today. So, do you want to just tell them a little bit about you?
Right, so my name's Meg. I am from Lincoln. I've travelled today. And I usually just do makeup and stuff, but yeah, today we're doing nails.
So on Instagram, how many followers have you got on Instagram?
400,000.
She's like, 400,000?
I hate saying that.
Yeah, just blow the trumpet. Come on, blow the trumpet.
You asked me.
So 400,000, that's pretty freaking amazing. I'd love to have 400,000.
How did you get started on building that up? That's a lot of people.
Basically, just started posting photos of myself when I was really young. It just went from there. My photos just started getting shared around and stuff.
Yeah.
Just literally within a week, I had like 100K.
That never happens to me.
No, Adam, I don't know why. Maybe you kept Meg to your face.
To me.
Yeah.
And then you'll be fine. You'll be well away. Yeah, so you are pretty amazing at makeup, though.
Well, you're amazing at nails.
Oh, thank you. It was a fabulous collaboration. Right, so I'm going to sculpt this nail out. I've already prepared the nail, so I've done all of the cuticle work, removed the surface shine, done all that. And now we're going to sculpt this nail, and we're going to do a ballerina nail. Now, Meg would say, I want a coffin nail.
It's not Halloween, love.
We're not doing coffin, we're doing ballerina, darling.
Ballerina sounds so much nicer.
It does, doesn't it? But it's a common word as the coffin.
I always think ballerina's pointed.
No. Not at all. I mean...
But the shoes are called points, aren't they?
Well, yeah.
Yeah, but they've got a block. They've got a block on the end, haven't they?
Like witch's feet.
Yeah. I think my feet would fit really nice into those because I've got really square feet. I hate my feet. You know, these shoes are in fashion, these transparent shoes.
Yeah.
It's like they're all pointed. Awful. My feet just look... horrendous in them.
Like you can see into the toes where they'll all be like crushed up like
yeah.
that.
Yeah. Aren't these are all in, but no.
I never have my toenails painted, so that's just awful.
Yeah, so that wouldn't be a good one for you. But yeah, I see like people wearing them and I think, oh, they look so nice. But then I try them on and go, oh my God, my feet are so ugly. So you normally have them quite long anyway, don't you?
Yeah.
So you can cope with them long.
It looks like I'm swearing at you.
Oh, thanks. What's your favourite makeup brand then? Do you have a favourite?
Probably Anastasia Beverly Hills.
Yeah. Why is that then?
I don't know. I just like their stuff. They have so much. They just have so much makeup.
What, the variety? So
yeah.
Good. The pigment's really good in it.
Everything, it's just such good quality.
Yeah. So, I'm going to dehydrate the nail now. And I'm going to use acid-based primer. There's a bit of fluff on there, let me just grab that with that. So just on the natural nail. So this Fendi design will be done with gel polish and also hand-painted design as well. So we're going to sculpt this nail out with natural beige. So we're just going to do a full ballerina nail. I don't need to do a clear base or anything like that because we're not going to put any colours in or glitter in or anything like that. We're literally going to sculpt it, the entire thing out in natural beige. So we're starting with the free edge. And we start with the free edge first because this will take longer to set, believe it or not, because it's not close to the finger. And the finger has warmth, and the warmth will make the acrylic set quicker. How long do you want to go? Longer? Should we just go to a three?
Yeah.
Yeah? Fays go to a three, don't they?
Four.
Get lost.
Yeah. Yeah, I think I remember seeing it go to a four.
Do you want a four?
It's normally 3.5, and then when you do a fill, it'll go to a four, and then sometimes it goes to a 4.5. Depending on how long it's taken for it to come back for a fill.
Okay, let's go even longer. I just know that Meg wants Faye style nails.
Love Faye's nails.
If you're new to the channel and you don't know what we're talking about, you need to check out
Worst nail client ever.
Yeah, the worst nail client ever videos. They are Faye. I am going to do this in 3 beads because it's such a long nail. So I'm now going to bring this bead down over the top of what we've just done, but I've moved slightly further back.
I love the smell of acrylic.
Do you?
It's just a nice smell.
So getting that cuticle area nice and neat, building up that apex, slidey, oily, because it's so young and supple.
Not because I've got greasy hands or anything, just because I'm young.
No, young and supple, and then I've got dehydrated skin like those older folks. This is a long nail.
I love when you pinch nails, it's iconic.
Alright, so we're going to pinch this now, it's started to set. That hurt.
Tiny bit.
Nothing.
She never flinched.
She
didn't flinch.
You're good. You can come again. So I'm checking the pinch down the barrel of the nail as well, making sure it flows all the way from here, all the way to the tip. If you listen to this here, that's set. See the difference in sound? That's not set yet. So even though we did this section first, it's still taking longer to set because of the warmth of the finger. It makes it set quicker. Right, so we're going to take this form off so you can see the curve runs all the way to the tip.
So long, I love it.
Still love it already.
I know.
So I'm gonna do my normal filing routine. I'm gonna file the side walls first. So buffed over that, made it nice and smooth, like a baby's butt. And I'm going to wipe over with acetone just to smooth it out even more, make it nice and super perfect. And then I'm going to use... So I'm going to apply butterscotch. Not actual butterscotch. This is what the gel polish is called. So I think this colour works nice with Fendi colours. I'm going to bounce that towards the cuticle, get it nice and crisp. So that's all I'm concentrating on, at this moment in time. Sweep round. And just drag that excess down. I'm going to pop that into the lamp and we're going to do two coats of that colour. I'm going to top coat this, but I'm going to do two top coats. I'm doing two top coats because I'm going to buff the top coat and I don't want to buff through the top coat into the colour. So if I do two, I know I've got that kind of safety blanket there. I'm buffing it because I'm going to paint on top of it. So I'm going to take a soft buffer and just remove the shine. It's a lot easier to paint on top of a buffed surface. The paint likes to attach really well to a buff surface. So you want to use a soft buffer or even an old buffer. You don't really want to use a brand spanking new one because you don't want to remove layers of colour. Then I'm going to wipe over with gel residue wipe off solution. I want to make sure there's no oil on there. That'll interfere with the paint as well. Look how matte that is, that's so nice.
That looks absolutely beautiful.
So we have here, I've got some of the bronze polycolour and also black polycolour. Mix them together to make kind of like a bronzy black, believe it or not.
Oh, you're
going to
say pink.
So, then I'm going to use a detail brush. I'll need some water. Let's put a little bit of that on my palette so I can keep adding it. We want it to flow nice, but we don't want it to lose pigment.
Do you not get nervous just like drawing stuff on a nail?
I don't like it. Quite like the bands actually on my dress here. I quite like the little.
Yeah, I like them bands.
I like the bands. Right, okay. So we're gonna use these bands here. We're gonna do them at the bottom, and we're gonna put these Fendi all over this nail. Now, this is going to be difficult, I'm not gonna lie. It won't be the easiest thing I've ever painted in all my life, but I'm gonna show you how to lay out this design. You can see that they come across the nail, well, across like this. So that's what you've gotta concentrate on. So we've got Fs that are normal, and then upside down Fs. Lots of Fs. And I'm going to start at this top corner. Right, okay, so we're going to start up here. So with the F, this part is longer than this one, and this is fatter. So I made a little mark there at the end of that F so that I could start with my other. The hardest thing with this is getting them all to look the same. So again, I'm going to make a mark there. So I know I'm going to do one here. And the more pressure you put on the brush, the wider the line will be. The lighter pressure, the thinner the line will be. So you can see when you do this part, you're going to do the light pressure. But when you do the main body of the F, So you've got your starting point there. And then we're going to come and do the upside down Fs along that line. And then you will work your way out from that. The only thing I'm going to do before I do anything else is we're going to do these lines at the bottom here. I'm going to do that with striping tape. So we're going to use, this is the, I think it's three millimeter tape, isn't it, this? If I'm, correct me if I'm wrong.
I have no idea.
I'm sure everybody will correct me if I'm wrong. So you can see I put the tape on and I have two little gaps there. So all I'm going to do now is take some of my paint. Paint over there. Now it doesn't matter if I go a bit messy with it because I have the tape there to help protect. I've just cut that so I can now grab this part and peel it off to reveal the stripes. And there's a bit of gold on it. We've got stripes, now we're going to put the upside down Fs. So if you remember, when you do this, they need to go as high and as low as the right way round Fs. So we have all of the Fs, all of the Fs, and I'm going to top coat now.
The nail looks so much shorter on camera than it does in real life.
I know, and it's so huge.
You know what, Kirsty?
What?
You cannot be accused of not giving an F.
Anymore. I give all the Fs. Now with the top coat you can see the slight shimmer to the Fs. Pop going to put another layer of top coat on because I'm going to buff this so it goes nice and matte. You don't have to, you could keep it nice and shiny. The reason I'm putting two coats of top coat on is because I don't want to buff through the F's, because I tell you what, if I fire through them F's that I've just painted, I will be extremely unhappy with myself. So I'm going to take a used buffer and buff over to make this nice and matte. Just going to quickly wipe over with gel residue wipe off solution.
Wow. I'm
going to check that it's all matte. And it is. Fendi. There you are, love it. There you are, guys, that's how to create a Fendi nail. Matte version or shiny version, what do you like? I prefer the matte one. So do you. What do you? Comment below. Everything that I've used today will be listed in the description box. As always, don't forget to check us out on Facebook and Instagram, and I will see you in the next video. It's bye from me. And this is where you say it's bye from me.
It's bye from me too.
If you want to follow Meg, we're going to put in the description box Meg's details of her Instagram and everything like that, because you need to follow this girl.